the next program that we write is to find out whether a number that is inputted by a user is divisible or exactly divisible by 10 or not. That is, write a program to check whether the inputted number is a multiple of 10 or not. That is very simple. If the number is 50, it is a multiple of 10. I will have to say yes, it is a multiple of 10. If it is, say, 55, then it is not a multiple of 10. I will have to say no, it is not a multiple of 10. Say it is 730. I will have to say yes, it is a multiple of 10. Say it is 736. I will have to say no, it is not a multiple of 10. So it is as simple as that. Write a program to check whether the inputted number is a multiple of 10 or not. Now, obviously, I will comment out the program, and I will go to start writing this program. Now, how to write this program? Very simple. See, the logic of the program, let me write all these formalities, stdio.h and everything. While I write, let us discuss how to write the program. The way of writing this program can be that I divide the number by 10 and find the remainder. What is the remainder? If the remainder is 0, then definitely it is divisible by 10. Say, for example, the number is 50. 50, if you divide it by 10 and check the remainder, that is 50% 10. If you remember, percentage is for checking the remainder. So if the 50% 10, the remainder definitely will be 0 in this case, because 50 is a multiple of 10. So 50 divided by 10 will give a 0 remainder. Now suppose the number was 56. Then if you divide it by 10, then the remainder will be 6, which means this number 56 is not divisible by 10. Any number which is ending with 0 or divisible by 10 will yield a remainder 0 if you divide it by 10. So my job is to check, after inputting the number, whether that number is divisible, whether that number, after dividing the number by 10, I will have to check whether the remainder is 0 or not. So very simple, I will divide the number by 10 and check the remainder. If the remainder is 0, I will say it is divisible by 10. If it is not 0, I will say it is not a multiple of 10. If it is not 0, the remainder is not 0. So let us start with the program. Clear screen. Definitely I need the number, so int number. I tell the user to enter the number. I tell the user to enter the number. I scan that number within the variable called number. Now I will have to check whether this number is divisible by 10. So if number percent 10, now what does it teach us? It teaches us that I can do any calculation within the if itself. If number percent 10 is equal to 0, if number percent 10 is equal to 0, that is, when the number is divided by 10, the remainder is 0, then you definitely say that the number is divisible by 10. Printf, the inputted number is a multiple of 10. Why do I take up this program? Maybe to show you that any operation is possible also within this if condition checking. So if number percent 10 is equal to 0, that is, number divided by 10, the remainder is 0, then you say that it is a multiple of 10. However, if the number divided by 10, the remainder is not 0, then it will not enter the if block. And what does it mean? It means that the number is not divisible by 10. So in the else part of the program, you can very easily write printf, the number is not a multiple of 10. You can do this very easily. So I can end the program, I can end the program over here, and I can say this program will actually tell you whether the number which you have inputted is divisible by 10 or not. The number divided by 10, remainder is 0, you will say that it is a multiple of 10, and the remainder is not 0, definitely it is not a multiple of 10. So let us run this program. Alt R, enter a number 56, not a multiple of 10. Alt R, enter 50, it is a multiple of 10. So I think you understand this very well, that how to write such programs. So you may be given the program in a more general way. That is, you can say, write a program to check whether, check out what I am changing, whether I inputted number X is a multiple of another inputted number, inputted number Y. Can the program be given to me like this? Definitely it can be. You may be given to check that whether a inputted number X is a multiple of another inputted number Y, which means user over here will input two numbers, one number as X and the other number is as Y. My job is to check as a programmer whether the inputted number X is a multiple of the inputted number Y. Don't you think this is too easy? X when divided by Y, if the remainder is 0, then definitely X is a multiple of Y. Say the two numbers are 40 and 8. So you divide 40 by 8, if the remainder is 0, 40 divided by 8 is 5, remainder 0. So 40 divided by 8, if the remainder is 0, then definitely that number is a multiple of 40 is a multiple of 8. So check out what I did say right now. 40 and 8 are the two numbers inputted. So if I divide 40 by 8 and check that the remainder is 0, I automatically understand that it means that 40 is a multiple of 8. So I will have to check for X and Y, and I will have to see whether X is X divided by Y, the remainder is 0. If so, I say X is a multiple of Y. So I take the two numbers X and Y. So I tell him enter two numbers to check whether one is a multiple of the other. This is what my program logic is. I just need to check whether one number is a multiple of the other number. So I tell the user, enter two numbers to check whether one is a multiple of the other. I just write it like this. So scanf, I do need to scan two numbers, scanf %d %d, maybe ampersand x comma ampersand y, which means I will have to divide x by y and check. So here what I need to do is, if x percent y, let's check out, if x percent y is equal to 0, then I can say the inputted number, the first inputted number, is a multiple of the second inputted number. Isn't that so? So I just need to write this, and if x percent y is not equal to 0, then it will not enter the if block, and if it does not enter the if block, it will enter the else block, where I can say the first inputted number is not a multiple of the second inputted number. Isn't that so? So I can do exactly this. So over here I can end the program. You can understand it very well. I have divided x by y and checked the remainder. If the remainder is 0, I said that it is a multiple. If the remainder is not 0, I have said no, it is not a multiple. Let us run Alt R, enter. Enter two numbers to check whether one is a multiple of the other. So let me enter 40 and 8 again. 40 and 8, the first inputted number is a multiple of the second inputted number. So again I run Alt R, maybe 56 and 6. So definitely 56 is not exactly divisible by 6. When you divide 56 by 6, it is 9, remainder 2. So the first inputted number is not a multiple of the second inputted number. So understand this very well. So you can make the program even better. You could have written the first inputted number X, that is, you exactly use the number, the first inputted number %d is a multiple of the second inputted number %d. And what are these two percentages? Tell me. First is x, the second is y. So the first inputted number x, the value of x will replace this percentage, the value of y will replace this percentage. So the first inputted number is a multiple of the second inputted number. Same way over here, first inputted number percentage is not a multiple of the second inputted number percentage. So let me run this program once more. Before that, x and y must be there to replace these two percentages. So you understand this? What change does it make? It will just say more clearly, the output will be given more clearly. Alt R enter to a two numbers 40 and 8. The first inputted number 40 is a multiple of the second inputted number 8. You run the program once more. 41 and 7, definitely not. The first inputted number 41 is not a multiple of the second inputted number 7. It is as simple as that. So I think you understand this. Again, you can take a bit of break, and if once we come back, we will come out with some other interesting program.